Welcome to Audio Video System Playlist. I, Professor Hitesh Dholakia, is going to explain you Vidicon camera in this session. So to understand Vidicon camera, these are my session outlines.
So first, I'll be going to explain basics of Vidicon camera. Then we will see its structure, components in Vidicon camera, and then we will see working of each component in Vidicon camera. And after that, I'll be going to explain you what is the light transfer characteristics which is there with Vidicon camera. And then we will see a few applications of Vidicon camera. And at the end, I'll sum up this session by explaining advantages and disadvantages of Vidicon camera. So let us begin this session with first agenda, that is basics of Vidicon camera. So Vidicon camera that came in general use in early 1950s, and it have gained immediate popularity, and that is because of its small size and ease of operation. So this camera have invented in 1950s, and it have gained popularity because of its size and ease of operation. So we will see all those things in detail step by step. See, its function is basically based on the principle of photoconductivity, where based on light intensity, resistance of photoconductive surface will change. If light intensity is more, then resistance of photoconductive surface that will be less, and if light intensity is less, in that case resistance of photoconductive surface that will be more. See, that is how inverse relation is there. So that even I'll explain you in working. So one should know principle of operation that is based on photoconductivity. If you see the dimensions of Vidicon camera, then it is having length which is varying from 12 to 20 centimeter, and its diameter that is even in the range of 1.5 to 4 centimeter. So this camera in 1950s, so that was one can say this was compact camera at that time. Right, so that was upgraded version at that time. Right now we have very good cameras, but previously this size of camera was very good, that was considered in that sense. Its life that is been estimated in between 5000 to 20000 hours. So life of that camera was about 5000 to 20000 hours, and resistance of surface that changes in between 2 mega ohm to 20 mega ohm for bright to dark spot. So for bright spot resistance is 2 mega ohm, and for dark spot that resistance is 20 mega ohm. So that is how resistance is there for a different spot. Now let us see its component and working step by step, so it will be a bit more clear. So see, here you can see the object which we are a little bit to televised, and first of all the light which is there with this object that will pass through the lens of Vidicon camera. So see, whatever object is there, based on object light proportion will enter in this lens and it will go in this direction. Now first this light will pass through a glass plate, and after that that light will pass through a conductive coating. Now see, this conductive coating that is having characteristic like its resistance that will change with respect to intensity of light which is coming from here. So whatever object is there, it is having two categories, bright spot and dark spot for black and white TV. So dark spot that is having higher resistance on this conductive coating, and light spot that is having lower resistance. And how that is happening, that even we are a little bit to learn step by step. So let us see further components, so it will be a bit more clear. Now see, here there will be photoconductive surface. See, this conductive coating, from where we will be taking our output electrical signal of this Vidicon camera, and this photoconductive surface on which we will be bombarding electron beam. So how we are bombarding that electron beam, that even we will see step by step. See, this is what complete tube, and in this tube, see, this is electron gun, and that electron gun is fed with this cathode. So once you apply supply to this cathode, it will emit electron beam. You can see this electron beam that is emitted on this photoconductive surface. Now let us consider one spot here first of all. So for this one spot, if it is a dark spot, in that case you will be finding for this conductive coating resistance will be less. Sorry, resistance will be more for a dark spot, and for bright spot that resistance will be less, and that resistance variation that is there in between 2 mega ohm to 20 mega ohm. So for bright spot resistance is 2 mega ohm, and for dark spot that resistance is 20 mega ohm. And this is what about one pixel only, but we are dealing with to scan this beam. So to have scanning operation, we need to steer this beam, and that I have explained in scanning. We are dealing with to have horizontal and vertical scanning, and that horizontal and vertical scanning, that we do it by steering this electron beam, and that movement of electron beam, that we do it by having magnetic deflection and focusing coil. So here this is magnetic deflection and focusing coil that will be doing scanning operation of this electron beam. So based on the position of electron beam, there will be object, and that object will be having dark and bright spot, and based on that resistance of this photo conductive coating will change, and we provide this external biasing to this conductive coating, and from here we will be taking video electrical signal. Now see what will happen is, over here resultant electrical signal that will be in proportion with light intensity which is happening over here. If light intensity is more, in that case resistance will be less, and if resistance is less, in that case current passing over here at video electrical output will be more. And if dark spot is appearing, in that case resistance will be more, and in case of resistance is more, here you will be observing there is lower amount of current. So that is how you will be having scanning over here, and based on scanning automatically here video electrical signal will get generated. And this is what the basic working which is there with Vidicon camera. And electron beam which is getting scanned over here, that has been accelerated by accelerator grid over here first, and that has been provided with 300 voltage. And there are a few more grids. One is focusing grid. So that focusing grid will ensure that this electron beam should focus on this photoconductive surface only. And at the end, there is deacceleration grid, which is there just nearer to this photoconductive surface. And that is to deaccelerate motion of electron, which is happening in this direction. And this deacceleration is required. Why? The reason is, this electron beam may damage this photoconductive surface. So life of this camera that may degrade as if you have higher velocity of electron beam over here. So at the end, we reduce velocity of that electron beam by providing deacceleration grid. So by having this deacceleration grid, we can increase life of this camera. So here, see, in this Vidicon camera, working is based on photoconductive surface, where based on light intensity of object, resistance will change, and based on that we generate video electrical signal, and that output that we take it from here. So this is what about Vidicon camera and its working. Now I'll explain you light transfer characteristic of Vidicon camera. So in light transfer characteristic, for horizontal axis there is a luminance, and that you can see that is been written here in terms of logarithmic scale 0.01, 0.1, 1.0 up to 1000. So that is there in logarithmic scale. And here on y-axis there is output current, that is even there in logarithmic scale. Now here one thing that we need to understand in this graph, and that is a slope of line. So whatever slope that is there with this line on this graph, that explains sensitivity of camera. So whenever you see any video camera, for light transfer characteristic, in that case we should understand this slope of line in light transfer characteristics explains sensitivity of camera. So higher the slope of line, higher the sensitivity of camera, that one can say. So this we should understand every time. Higher the slope, higher the sensitivity. Now I'll show you a few cases. See, this is one line which is there for a dark current. Now in previous diagram, if you see, this is what target voltage, this V, that is a target voltage. So that is there in your hand. So this is to change intensity of light which is coming from here. If you want higher contrast, in that case you can increase this voltage. If you want lower contrast, then you can decrease this voltage. So this is referred as target voltage. Now here, as I have told you, one graph that is there for one dark current. Dark current means there is a dark spot, and for that this reading is taken. Now relatively you can understand, if I increase that target voltage, you can see this line that is actually moving upward, right? And this line for another higher target voltage. So if you observe these lines, as I increase target voltage, this line is moving upward. Now here from these lines, one thing that we need to understand, so those points are, see, each curve that is there for dark current with different target voltage. And you can observe dark current and sensitivity will increase as you increase target voltage. Now see how that is happening. When you see this at first look, you will be finding slope of each line is same. But try to understand, this slope is not same. The reason is this graph is logarithmic graph. It is not linear graph. It is logarithmic graph. So in that, you just see change in y divided by change in x. So for this yellow color line, change in y, see, that is having highest target voltage. So if you see this change in y for these two boxes, that change is 1 micro ampere current, right, divided by change in x, that is luminance. So that is 10 minus 0.1. So that is what the slope, 1 micro ampere per 10 luminance, that is a slope of this highest target voltage. Then little lower than that, that is having, see, this slope. So that is 0.1 minus 0.01 divided by 10 minus 1 means 9. So if you calculate slope of this three line, so you'll be finding slope of yellow color line, that is highest, and slope of red color line, that is lowest. So as I have told you, as you increase target voltage, sensitivity will increase and dark current will increase, that you can see it in this graph, right? So this is what about characteristic based on target voltage, and that will generate certain amount of electrical signal which will be video electrical signal, and that we can play it on television even. And one more thing that we need to understand, that is photoconductive lag will increase as you increase target voltage. So as you increase target voltage, photoconductive lag even will increase. Now let us see applications of Vidicon camera. So earlier Vidicon were used only where there was no fast movement because of inherent lag. So in 1950s, we were not been having that facility of camera, where you can have fast movement of video. But nowadays, I think you might be observing, even with mobile camera, there is ultra slow motion facility, right? But at that time, that facility was not there, and even normal fast movement even cannot be recorded during 1950s, right? So these applications were having slides, pictures and television applications. But as time progresses, there was some improvement in lag and some broad applications that I have found for this Videcon camera. And those applications were based on education, medicine, industry, aerospace, oceanography, and most popular is in television. So those were been applications of Videcon camera in 1950. Now let us see the advantages and disadvantages. So let us discuss first advantages. See, cost is low, adjustment is very simple, large sensitivity is there. Right now, these are the advantages that I'm saying, but that is based on 1950s, right? So you just consider that in your mind. It is not about current cameras. It was the case which was there with 1950s camera. Good resolution was there with order of 350 lines. So that was considered as good resolution. Nowadays we have 4K recording facility. And if you see the disadvantages at that moment, then that disadvantage was like, it was having an issue with bright portion. So for very bright portion of image, faded image is left behind it. So you will be finding like as motion is happening, but for bright spot, that spot will get stick somewhere and it will disappear after some time. So you will not feel actual motion in video. For bright spot, it was the case which was the major case, where in motion you will be finding like for bright spot, it will not disappear immediately, right? So that was the disadvantage. Non-linearity in response was there. So that is what the case which is there with Videcon camera.
Thank you so much for watching this video. I would like to get your suggestions from your side. The reason is I want all those topics that has to be covered on my channel so that students can easily learn everything which is required in the university courses. And you can download all this material which I am teaching here from my application Engineering Funda. So I am providing all those material free of cost. You can download it. It will be easier to you to learn all those topic which I am teaching here. Again, thank you so much for watching this video, and your suggestions are most welcome to me. So please do give your valuable suggestions, which is highly required here to optimize this channel.